Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can print reverse of array in C programming. So I will be explaining three different methods so that you can print reverse of array. So these three methods will be related to C programming. So do watch the complete video so that you can get to know how we can use three different ways to print reverse of array. Before starting, just one update. If you go to a detail or description of this video, you can see various links of a playlist related to C programming. So you can follow them if you want to watch more programming related videos. Now I'm going to explain method number one first. So first of all, I'm going to read one array. So this is the declaration of array along with one variable I. Now to read that variable from user, I'm going to print this message. Then I'm iterating a loop which will run 10 times and it will read 10 different numbers and those numbers will be stored inside A array, right? So these three statements are for reading array from user. Now after reading all these 10 elements, now I'm going to tell you method number one, like how you can print those elements in reverse order. So let me first explain the meaning of reverse. So let's say this is our array and it is having these values. And these are the indexes. So these are values and these are index. Now the output of this will be 20, then 19, then 18 and so on. So this means reverse. So reverse means first we need to print the last element of array, then second last element and so on. So now after this reading, I'm going to print a message. Reverse of array, and after this message I am going to print each element starting from last. So I am going to use a loop which will start from line. I am going to start a loop which will start from line, then its condition will be I greater than equals to 0 and then I plus plus, right? Sorry, I minus minus. And then I'm going to write printf backslash n percent d, and here I can write e of I and closing of main function. So here you can see I'm starting loop from 9. So 9 is this position. So value of I is 9, which is greater than or equals to 0. So this printf will print a of 9. So a of 9 means 20. So first 20 will be printed on output screen. Then I minus minus, I will become 8. Check this condition, it is again true. So this time it will print value of A 8 index, that is 19. So 19 will be printed on output screen. So this way this loop will go till 0 because last index is 0. That's why I placed greater than equals to. Then value of I will be minus 1, then this loop will be terminated. So this way you understood the method one, that is printing all the elements of array in reverse order. So in this method one, I can also change this loop so that it will start from 0 and it will go to 9 and still it will print the reverse of array. So I am changing it starting with 0. Condition is I less than 10 and here I am using I plus plus. Now see carefully what I am going to do. I am putting this A of 9 minus I. So see it carefully now. I is 0 at the beginning. Condition is less than 10, which is true. Now solve this. 9 minus I. So I is 0. So first time it will become A9. So A9 means 20 will be printed on output screen. Then I will be incremented to 1. So next time A, 9 minus 1, so it means it will provide A of 8. So A of 8 is 19, so 19 will be printed on output screen. Then I will be incremented to 2, so 9 minus 2 will be 7. So this way, with this expression, you are able to identify the indexes in reverse order so that we can print array in reverse order. So this way, along with method 1, you can use two arrays. You can start it from 0 to 9, or you can start it from 9 and you can terminate it to 0. So I hope you understood the method 1. Now I am going to explain method number 2. So I am removing these statements. So in method 1, you saw that the values of array is still in the order which is provided by the user. We just printed it in reverse order. We didn't change the elements order actually that is available inside the array. Now if you want, 20 will be available at 0 position, 19 will be available at 1 position, and 11 will be available at last position, 12 will be available at second last position, this way. So in that case, we can use method number 2. So I am going to declare one more variable as array, that is B, right? Now here I am going to write printf reverse of array, then again for loop, so it will repeat 10 times from 0 to 9. Now I am going to assign this 0th index at last position of second array. So let's say this is second array. And its name is B. So you will see 11 will go here, 12 will go here, and this way it will be having reverse of A. So we need to store elements in B from A. So here we need to put indexes so that we can assign values. So we are starting from this 0. So I am putting A of I. Right? Now this A of I means A of 0 position will go to B9. So here I am putting 9 minus I. Now let's solve it. Initially I will be 0. So A0 position, that is 11, will be assigning to B9 minus I. So I is 0. So it means B9. So B9 position will be having 11. Then I will be incremented. I will be 1. So A1, that is 12, will be assigning to B8, because 9 minus 1, I is 1. So 8 position will be having 12. Next time I will become 2. So A of 2 position is 13, and 9 minus 2 is 7. So 13 will move here at 7th index of B8. So this way we are copying individual elements of A array from the beginning and putting them into B array starting from last. So this way B array will be having all the elements in reverse order. So I am closing this. After completion of this, I can rotate one more loop starting from 0 to 10. And this will print the elements which are stored in B array and I index. So after complete rotation, it will be having values like this. It will be having values like this. So A is having values in the order which is provided by the user. B array is having all the elements in reverse order. So B is having reverse of A. Now I am going to print B. So I is starting from 0. So B0 will print 20. then B1 will print 19, then 18, then 17. So this way, reverse of A will be printed on output 2. Right? So this was method 2. So in method 1, you saw the drawback. We were just printing elements in reverse order on output 3. In actual memory, we were not having reverse of array. But in method 2, we are printing reverse of array on output screen, as well as we have the reverse of array in memory as well. But here you can see we have two arrays. We have two arrays. So it means we are wasting memory if we are using this second array. Right? So this problem will be resolved by method 3. So in case of method 3, you will be having reverse of array printed on output screen, as well as reverse of array in memory, and you don't require any extra array. So what we will be doing, we will be doing reverse of this A array internally in memory, right? So I'm erasing this, and now I'm going to tell you how we will do that. So I'm removing this as well, because now we don't require any additional array. So we will be having variable I and variable j. Now I am going to explain requirement of method 3, what we are going to do. So we are going to swap elements. We are going to swap elements. First and last will be swapped, then second and second last, third and third last, fourth and fourth last, and fifth last. All the elements will be swapped. So if we swap these elements, so 20 will be available here and 11 will move here. So this way, we don't require any extra memory, any extra array, and within the same array, you will be having the reverse of array, and then you can print that array on output screen. So this is my method number 3. So now I'm going to implement the logic for this, then I will explain how it will be working. So here I am writing one loop that is starting from 0, then I am placing comma and putting j equals to 9. So see carefully, here I am using two variables for initialization purpose, and I just provided comma in between, not semicolon. Semicolon will come after this. Now I am writing the condition, it is I less than j. So loop will repeat till I is less than the value of j. Then I am going to increase value of I, comma, I am going to decrease value of j. So again, to increment or decrement operation, so I am putting comma in between, and before that I am using semicolon. So remember that we can use multiple variables for initialization. We can use multiple variables for increment and decrement. Now here I am going to swap values of these two locations. So I'm going to use one more variable as t, temporary variable. So here I'm writing this. So this way, this loop will perform swapping of array so that we can have reverse of array. So now, be with me so that you can understand how this process will work. So initially I will be 0 and j will be 9. Initially I will be 0 and j will be 9. Check this condition. It is true, I is less than j. Perform this. So this is simple swapping operation. We using third variable. So a of I will go to t, a of j will go to I, and t will go to j. So it means, I hope you already know how this swapping operation works. So 11 will be replaced with 20. This will happen with this logic. And if you want to know this as well, so I am explaining this. A of I, so initially A 0. So A 0 was 11. So initially it was 11 and it was 20. So I'm going to explain this for first rotation only so that you can understand this. So A0 is 11, so T will be 11. Now AJ, J is 9, so A9th index is having 20, which will go to A, zero position. So A zero position will be 20. Now we need to assign T into AJ. So AJ is 9, A9. So this position will be having 11. So this way we are swapping two elements with this one. Then I will be incremented to 1 and J will be decremented to 8. Check this condition. And I hope you understood what will be the next step. We again going to swap two elements. So element that is available at 1 index and available at 8 index will be swapped. So 1 index is 12, 8 is 19. So this way it will swap. Right? Then I will be 2, J will be 7. So here it will be 18 and here 13. Then I3 and J will be 6. So 3 is 14 and 6 is 17. So 17 will be here and 14 will be here. Then I4 and J5, right? So 4, 5 will be swapped. So here 16 and then 15. Then I will be 5 and J will be 6. So now check this condition. Sorry, it will be 4 because we need to decrease J. So J will be 4. So now check this condition. I is 5 and J is 4. So this condition is false. So in this situation, this loop will be terminated. And here you can see array is arranged in reverse order. So 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, and 11. All are arranged in reverse order. So we did only 5 rotation of loop. And with 5 rotation, we swapped 10 elements. Because in one rotation, we are shifting position of two elements, right? And after this, you can print a message. Reverse of array. And then you can start loop from 0 till 9. And with this loop, you can print the value of A of I. And then you can close your main function. So this way this array will be printed on output screen with this loop in reverse order. So method 3 is explaining how we perform reverse in memory as well, and we printed reverse on output screen as well. So I hope you understood each method, method 1, method 2, and method 3. So each have their own advantages and drawbacks. So there are 3 various methods so that you can print a reverse of array on output screen. So try all them in your laptop so that you can understand how they are working. And if you watch more programming related videos, so again, you can open my channel, go to playlist, there you will see various videos available. And you can also go to detail or description of this video where you will be having a playlist related to C programming. And I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. So thank you for watching this video.